In 1795, Excelsior, a military brig with a crew of 120, was sailing along the coast with the transport of weapons and ammunition for the northernmost fort of our country. The weather was good and the trip promised to be short and enjoyable. However, on the day of June 12, the ship disappeared without a trace. Preliminary searches found no wreckages or survivors and assumed that Excelsior must have hit an unmapped underwater rock. Perhaps the accident happened at night and the crew could not launch the boats in time. Or maybe the ship had encountered a rare and unusually powerful water tornado and was completely destroyed in a few minutes. Yet, 3 months later, on September 14, Excelsior was returning to her base harbor in good condition. 31 members of the crew were missing while the survivors were ready to tell the world an incredible story. Three short stories in a novel. The novel is told from the perspective of Alberto Shimada, the second officer on board. He experiences a trek of discovery and adventure in a strange universe, initially in his quest to return to his crew, from whom he was separated by unexpected circumstances, then in his struggle to be reunited with his love. Excerpt. Once upon a time, I, Chuang Tzu, dreamed I was a butterfly, fluttering hither and thither, to all intents and purposes a butterfly. I was conscious only of my happiness as a butterfly, unaware that I was Tzu. Soon I awoke, and there I was, veritably myself again. Now I do not know whether I was then a man dreaming I was a butterfly, or whether I am now a butterfly, dreaming I am a man. Between a man and a butterfly there is necessarily a distinction. The transition is called the transformation of material things. I wake up in the middle of the night, thinking about the words of the great sage. I hear some noises in front and see a small fire still burning in front of me. An improvised spear and stone axe lay on the floor to my left. Where am I? Where is the great cave with the luminous ceiling and the edible mushrooms? I feel totally lost. Then, slowly, my memory comes back. It is the early morning of June 20th. I got lost from my people during the fight on the island and am following the river to the sea in order to rejoin them. The entrance of the little cave is jammed with many pieces of wood tied with vines. And from outside, some unknown beast tries to get in. Still dizzy from my vivid dream, it felt like I lived in it for 9 days. I am taking a burning branch and come closer to the entrance. Behind the trembling shadows, I see a large lizard-like animal scratching the improvised wooden door. A quick sting with my primitive spear makes it retreat for now with an angry roar. The dawn is near and I hope to have a quiet morning, but I know the creature will come again at nightfall, when I might not be so lucky with my shelter anymore in case I chose to continue my trip.